एवरीवन, टुडे यू विल स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट बीट, दैट इज द कोएंजाइम्स, इंक्लूडिंग इट्स डेफिनेशन, समरी एंड फंक्शंस. नाउ सी व्हाट इज मीन बाय द कोएंजाइम्स. दीज आर द ऑर्गेनिक मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफन डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम द बीटा कॉम्प्लेक्स और बी कॉम्प्लेक्स ग्रुप विटामिन्स. ओके, सो दीज आर द ऑर्गेनिक मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑब्टेंड फ्रॉम द बी कॉम्प्लेक्स ग्रुप विटामिन. Second is that they participate in the enzyme reactions directly, means they involved in the enzymatic reactions directly. So by considering these two points, the definition is the enzymes, or you may call many enzymes, catalyze the reactions only in presence of a specific non-protein organic molecules that we call the coenzymes. So coenzymes that catalyze the reaction only in presence of specific non-protein organic molecule called as coenzymes. Or another definition is that a substance necessary for the activity of certain enzyme. Activity of certain enzyme is done by a substance that we call the coenzyme. Moving towards the next, that is the characteristics. So which are the simple one? First, they are stable towards heat. Second, they are derived from vitamins, as I said in the definition. They function as a co-substrate. So stable towards the heat, obtained from vitamins, and function as a co-substrate. And fourth one, they participate in the both electron transfer reaction and group transfer reaction. So here the example is also given for these two. So these are the characteristics of the coenzymes. Moving towards the next, that is the functions of coenzymes, which are the simple. First, they are required in the oxidoreduction, group transfer and isomerization reaction. Means these are involved in both processes. First, oxidation and reduction process or group transfer, and second, isomerization reaction. Second function of the coenzyme is that they required in the reactions resulting in the formation of covalent bond. So the covalent bond is obtained when the coenzyme participate in that reaction. Third is that they accept a atom or group from one substrate and transfer them to the other molecule. They get atom or group from one substrate and transfer them to the other one. Fourth, they function as a hydrogen acceptor, that is NAD and NADP. So they have the both functions as a hydrogen acceptors in NAD as well as NADP. Moving towards the next functions of the coenzymes, they carry an active aldehyde group. Okay. They carry an active aldehyde group. For example, is the tripentophosphate. Sixth one, these are used in the synthesis of pyruvic acid, again synthesis of acetylation, and synthesis of purines and pyrimidines. So coenzymes are used in the synthesis of what? Synthesis of pyruvic acid, synthesis of acetylation, synthesis of purines, and synthesis of pyrimidines. Seventh is that they are involved in the transamination reaction, the reaction in which transfer of amine is take place. So in the transfer of amine, coenzymes are involved. For example, pyridoxal pyrophosphate. Eighth number is that the biotin involved in the CO2 fixation reaction, and vitamin B12 involved in the carbon chain isomerization. So the biotin and vitamin B12 both are the nothing but the coenzymes. Okay, as vitamins are the coenzymes, so the biotin is a vitamin, itself a coenzyme, and vitamin B12 also the itself coenzyme. So both these coenzymes involved in the CO2 fixation reaction and the carbon chain reaction. So these are the total 8 functions of the coenzymes. Thank you. Remaining bit we will cover in the next video.